Sebastian Eugene Arthur, who is a virologist, and he's joining us on phone. Good morning, and thank you for joining us.
Good morning.
It's good to have you. But first of all, I want to understand, do you think it was a bad decision by the president to call off the lockdown?
Well, I think we can look at this in two ways. One of the ways which I think is wise to do, I think the president has made a decision and is backed by evidence from numbers, right? Statistics. So, to me, it's a good decision. Now, the other side, most people are complaining about it being a bad decision. And I think for the most part, it's because of people comparing, you know, Ghana to Italy, Ghana to US, Ghana to all the other countries that are suffering severe situations, you know. World Health Organization has given guidelines as to what we have to do, you know, before we can lift a ban. One is transmission control. So you have to be sure that your transmission is controlled. The question is, do we have transmission control in Ghana? My answer is somehow. Now, this is why I say somehow.
Okay.
Whatever we have right now, whatever numbers we have right now, is something that we have gotten from a test we went to do voluntarily. Now, if we had waited in the hospitals, in all our clinics and all that, to just have people come to report, I don't think we have cases. Remember, most of the cases from the 124 or 132 are people who are asymptomatic, which means that they will not even come to the hospital or think about seeking medical attention. Now, we have a 3-week ban, which means that if we really were closed down in our houses or in our local areas, then within that 3 weeks, if you really have symptoms, you will, it will manifest and you will report it.
Okay.
If you are being honest. So now that we did not have any severe issue where people were calling in, you know, coming to check and we get samples, that's when we can say, okay, the issue is increasing, transmission is ongoing. Now, this is where we are actually taking the cases from a localized area or places where people are locked down. So the transmission is ongoing. I don't know if you get the point. It is not ongoing from the data we have.
All
right. Now, another thing is, why did we actually institute this lockdown? The thing is to make sure that our healthcare system is not incapacitated. And when I say that, I mean, we don't really want to wait. Just more cases, and then we come, you know, like allow people to just go about their daily activities. The transmission goes, you know, between us and then most people are sick. That is where our healthcare system will be overwhelmed because most people need healthcare facilities to be able to contain their symptoms and all that.
Sebastian.
So now that we are locked down, we have 1,042 people, most of who are asymptomatic. Those who are asymptomatic, they will go to the hospital. The number is so low so that our healthcare system can take care of them. Now, in the future, the president stated that they have visited places and then set aside certain places for testing, tracing, and the last one was, testing, tracing, and those one was, anyway, treating. So we have places for that, we have capacity for that. So, yes, we can go ahead and open the system so people can go about their daily activities. However, remember, it is only the lockdown that is removed. Only the lockdown that is removed. I'll say it again that we have to follow the necessary precautions in place. If you don't have anything to do in town, the lockdown still should be with you, not the government. It should be with you. For instance, I don't have anything to do in town. I'm home. I don't have to move about. You know, if you have to go to work, the face mask is necessary.
Okay. But if you're saying...
And therefore, the lockdown shouldn't be a problem to most of us.
Okay, but if you're saying that, you know, the onus lies on us as individuals to protect ourselves. Now, first of all, the conversation has started about us not being able to reach the masses by translating into the local languages. We were yet to even see that rollout from government, from the Bureau of National Languages as well. Now, that is yet to hit the masses who need to really understand how severe the issue is so they can protect themselves. And you clearly saw what happened yesterday. It may not be majority of us, but you saw people jubilating and dancing, and they threw the social distancing protocol to the curb. So really, if you're saying it's up to us and we have not been able to educate the masses as much, how then do we protect ourselves now that the lockdown has been lifted?
That is a very good question, Bella. Let me just also reiterate what I've been saying all the time, that I really have a problem with our announcement of those public instructions. Okay, this is because at first, before we say anything, we masses. Mm-hmm. As to what to do when this is set. So very good is the point. I actually have it written down here, and then I'll be saying it anywhere I go, that before we say anything, I don't know if Kobe Okonkoma Honorable will be listening to me.
Yeah.
Before we come out to say anything, we have to make sure that the public understands exactly what it is. Because when the lockdown was initially mentioned, when students were asked to go home, you saw what happened at the beaches. They were dancing, they were moving about. They don't really get the logic behind a lockdown. They don't get the logic behind social distancing. We don't even understand what a mask is and what it is used for.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm very blunt. Our minister, the way they use the mask, when you look at parliament and proceedings, you know, these are kind of things that we need to actually educate the public on before we allow certain things to be effective. So, for instance, lockdown is lifted. What about all other things? The president stated them that, remember, he just mentioned them, no one was able to explain every detail of what he said. And this is what has to be done. Now, my NGO, Vacation Initiative in Science, Africa, we deal with social design with children. And we are willing to actually go out there and train new people, I mean, educated, non-educated, about the rules that are set in place to help us to combat this disease. Mm-hmm. I don't know if someone is going to take us on, but if we get an opportunity, that is what we want to do. Educate people on what has been said. Most people heard about coronavirus, they don't know what it is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, some people have not been tracked at all. They know there's a disease going on. Someone said, I think part of the area that. I mean, you know, these are some of the things that we need to really look into. We need to talk about.
Yeah.
When we come out there and take rules and regulations, fair enough, we don't really understand. No.
Okay. Now, talking about how Ghana is managing the situation, I mean, of course, from judging from the way the president spoke, it looked like it was a speech of success in terms of managing the situation and doing contact tracing. Because now we're the, number one country in Africa that's doing the most tests as per 1 million of the population as well. And so what could we be doing that works for us? I mean, aside contact tracing and making sure that we reach, we are ahead of the virus, what else could we be doing that is working for us? Hence, the reason for lifting the lockdown?
I think the first thing we actually did right was the border closure, okay, and we tried to maintain it closed as much as possible and the quarantining. Now, the reason why I said that is when you look at countries like UK, South Africa, and all the other countries, the lockdown came late, okay? Ghana did well. We came, someone will argue that we came late, but it was actually earlier than most of the countries. So the amount of cases in the country that were pre-existing were very low, you know, and that is why we didn't see anything. And trust me, some people are saying that you might have cases in there. The contact tracing and the surveillance we did, the regular surveillance we did, the intensive, you know, screening of people, were two things that were very important to help us contain this disease. I'm not saying it's contained totally, and I'm not saying the virus is gone from Ghana, but I'm saying that it has been minimized with this kind of procedure put in place. Remember, again, I'm saying that we have 3 weeks. Now, the virus has an incubation period of between 3 to 14 days, by which time you should be showing some symptoms. And if it is severe, people would have reported. Now, once we are home, you have an extra week to for the virus, the system to take care of the virus.
Mm.
Okay. Asymptomatic patients cannot go more than 3 weeks without showing anything. It's either the body took care of it totally, or you have some severe case coming up eventually. But with that duration, I don't think anyone can show any symptoms if you had the virus before the lockdown. So these are some of the things we did. The lockdown was very good for us.
Okay.
The data was excellent, and our contact tracing was on point.
Okay, now let's talk about the face mask, because I remember we had a conversation with you about the use of the face mask, and you weren't too keen on it, especially because you said that, you know, it depends on how well people use it. I mean, knowledge about the use of face mask is key. At this point where the president is asking us to make sure that we wear our face mask each time we step out and also adhere to social distancing, what advice do you have for Ghanaians before we wrap up on this conversation?
Yeah, I'm sure. Face masks to be used once you want to go out there. We've spoken a couple of people who should be using the face mask regardless. I think everyone has to use a face mask if you are going out there. Again, the virus is still under study. So face mask is really relevant. And before you use a face mask, please make sure that what you're having is appropriate. The question is, what is appropriate? I would ask that we get in touch with the FDA to come and give us advice. However, I was doing some research on CDC US, to see what it recommended. So they suggested that if you want to do your own mask from home with our material, you just select the material and then put it to a sunlight or maybe light in the house. And then look through. If you see much of the light penetrating, it is a no-no. But if you see less light, like very low light going through, it's okay. Now the word is okay. I didn't say it's excellent. Because what is actually appropriate to be used is what the doctors must use. And there will be so much pressure on it. If you want to use that, if you have at home, you can use this simple method. First of all, lift the material to the light. And
okay.
See how much light goes through. Just look through and see how much light goes through.
Okay.
And if it is not possible, just put two or three of the material together and look through. However, if the egg can come out and then give us advice, that would be appropriate. And this is what I've been saying. I'm sorry, I become so passionate about this.
It's fine.
Everything must go on very, very well. Don't
okay.
put the mask below your nose. And don't take the mask off when you are talking. And three, we should prevent ourselves from passing the mask.
Mm.
Once you sanitize your hands and then you put the mask on, you only touch the mask when your hands are sanitized again. And when
okay.
you're taking it off, you don't touch the face of the mask, you touch the side, the strap. That is where you remove the mask, you burn it, and then please you wash your hands.
Okay.
I think Philippine is doing a very good job because you have a video from World Health Organization showing that. Please, we must be careful with how we use the mask.
Okay.
However, you must use the mask.
All right. Thank you so much. Sebastian Eugene Arthur is a virologist, and he just gave us some advice on the use of face masks in the country. Thank you for speaking to us. Anita, what do you think?
Interesting comments, especially about Ghanaians now starting to adapt to using the face mask.
Yeah.
It's going to be quite difficult, I should say.
It would
be. Very, very difficult.
It would be. Now